When you want to install from this list of recommended apps without using network bandwidth, set up lots of devices, or you want to enable staff or educators to set up student PCs on your behalf, just use the Setup School PCs app to create a student PC provisioning package. Save it to a USB drive that you can plug into student PCs running Windows 10 Creators Update, and the PC will be ready to use once Microsoft's recommended education settings are applied. Let's start. Run the app and then click Get Started. Now click Sign In to connect PCs to Office 365, Azure Active Directory, and management services like Intune for Education. We don't want to skip this step because by signing in, student PCs will be connected to your school's cloud services and managing them later will be easier. To sign in our devices, we need to choose our work or school account. Click Continue and then enter our account details. Click Next once you've specified the account. You'll be asked to provide the user account and password. You'll then get a notification to allow the app to access your account. Let's click Accept to give Setup School PCs permission to access Microsoft Store for Education, read memberships, sign you in, and more. This account will show up as the account that Setup School PCs will use to connect school PCs to the cloud. Let's select the school's wireless network to allow student PCs to automatically connect to your school's network. If yours is not listed, you can add it here. Click Next if you added or selected a wireless network. Or click Skip to skip setting up a wireless network. Let's click Skip to see what happens. Got It will take you to the next page without setting up Wi-Fi. Add Wi-Fi will take you back to the Wi-Fi setup page. Let's go back and add Wi-Fi. Now let's assign a name to the student PCs. Naming it. Here it's important to remember that the name must be 5 characters or less, as Setup School PCs adds unique characters to the name to ensure all device names are unique. And clicking Next. Here we can specify other settings for the student PCs. You can install only the base Windows 10 image, let students save files to the desktop or documents folder on the student PC, optimize the device for use by a single user, allow guests to use student PCs without a school account, or change the default lock screen background or to use the school's custom lock screen background instead. Let's allow guests to use the student PCs. This will add a guest account button in the PC's sign-in screen. The Take a Test app puts a Take a Test button on the student's sign-in screen. Use it to allow keyboard text suggestions to appear on screen and to allow teachers to monitor online tests. Windows also locks things down so students can't access anything else while taking tests. When done, click Next. To add Microsoft Store for Education apps to all the PCs, we just select some from this list of recommended apps and click Next to review our settings, making sure they're all set up the way we need. We can click on any setting to go back and make any changes we wish. Then click Accept and you can save your settings by inserting a USB drive, selecting it on the screen, and clicking Save. Our provisioning package is ready, so we can get the student PCs lined up, plugged in, and ready for setup. With the PC off, or the PC on the first run setup screen, insert the USB flash drive and then turn on the PC to start setup. In Windows 10 Creators Update, the first run setup screen says, "Let's start with region." Is this right? Windows will recognize the provisioning package on the USB drive and start setting up the PC. You can remove the USB drive when you see the message that you can remove the media. If you have other PCs to set up, just use the USB drive and start provisioning another student PC. And that's it. Your school PCs are all set up.